In this video, we're talking about how to make money online and how beginners are making $100 to $700 a day with simple copy and paste strategies. More at that after the intro. Hey guys, how's it going? Mike Vasile here. Welcome to this video. Before we actually begin, I remind you that several spots have opened up for this week's free workshop, where it's the fastest and easiest way to make money online. We literally have a 62-year-old woman go from zero to 160 grand profit in 90 days, so sign up for it now. When I first started making money online, it was just overwhelming. So here I was as like a broke college kid studying to become a dentist in this dental program, trying to figure out how to make money online and figure out how to do advertising, Facebook ads, YouTube ads, Google ads, Shopify, dropshipping, Amazon FBA, Amazon Associates, KDP, Merch by Amazon. There was so much things that I was just complicated with, and I was just overwhelmed with what I actually needed to do to go ahead and make money. And because of that, I desperately wish that there was like a copy and paste method so that when I first got started, I could initially make money and kind of like have training wheels on so that as I grew into this business, I could take the copy and paste methods off, take the training wheels off, and make more money with this. And this is the fast way that I found out on the copy and paste strategy to make your first $100 a day to scale even to $100 to $700 a day. So the first copy and paste method that I realized was on eBay. Now, one of the things that I realized is I remember like typing in something like bunk bed, right? And I wanted to know exactly what people were doing to make money on eBay. So I remember scrolling down here and I noticed this thing right here. I'm like, okay, here's a $292 product. That's pretty interesting. What if I just go ahead and click on it, right? And as you can see, three have already been sold. So this person's making decent money, right? But then I went down here and I was like, huh, I found this interesting strategy that if I copy this thing right here and put it into Google, I can find out where else they're selling online, right? So what I would do is I would copy that entire thing, go over to Google and just literally copy and paste that entire thing in there. And what I realized is oh my God, they're also selling the exact same thing on Walmart. So with just simply copy and pasting the description, I found the exact same bunk bed, guys. Look at this, the exact same bunk bed, same pillows, same desk, same ladder, $240, and here on eBay, it's $290. So just like that, if I sold it on eBay and I made $292, I could literally take the money that I made from there and buy it at a cheaper price from Walmart and then ship it directly to the customer just by simply copy and pasting. Think about that, I didn't do much work. All I did was found a product that I could sell on one platform and buy it with the customer's money on another platform. Think about how beautiful that is. You know, like back in the day, like the business gurus are like, oh, buy low, sell high, buy low, sell high, buy low, sell high. But what if you don't have any money to buy low in the first place? Like what I did when I was a struggling biology student, right? I did not have any money to buy low. I was on the dollar menu diet, the ramen noodle diet. I couldn't afford anything, right? So how could I buy anything for low? That's when I realized the secret. The secret is selling high, taking the customers in for money, and then buying low and then shipping it directly to them. So that's what I realized. I was like, oh my God, I could do the exact same thing. I would come over to Walmart, literally save the image as, and you have like this really complicated like title thing here. I would change it already automatically to like bunk bed. And then I would click on save. The reason why I would actually want to do that is because when you save an image with a specific keyword that people are searching for, it makes it easier to be found on eBay. And notice on eBay, I typed in bunk bed and that's exactly what like popped up, right? It was like all of these things that people are searching for, right? Now that I actually have the image, I would create the same listing, literally copy and paste the image that is on Walmart, and I would literally post it onto eBay. Now what else would I copy and paste? I copy and pasted the image, now it's on here. What else would I copy and paste? The title. No, I would not copy and paste the title. I would copy and paste the title differently to different keywords. So notice that there's bunk bed, there's all these keywords I would pop up. The only thing that I would copy and paste with the headlines are for similar projects and furnitures and different things. So I would do bunk bed, four kids, loft, full, twin, children's bedroom, furniture, safe with desk. You're probably wondering, Mike, that is like the most ridiculous title. Why on earth and why the hell would you ever kind of like make that as a title? Well, the thing is because people might find me for the word bunk bed, or they might find me because, for example, they put in the word like children's furniture. The reason why I want to do that is because then I could start ranking for a different keyword other than, you know, like bunk bed. I could be like in one of these things, right? That way, you know, when people are searching for this, they'll see like my bunk bed and they're like, oh my God. And it's not competing against other bunk beds, right? If I just do even like bedroom furniture, if I put that in the title, I could be found for all these other products that are going for like $1,000 to $600. So then the price of, you know, $290, like what this is going for, doesn't look like that much, right? So what you put in the title is very important. How you do that is you literally just use what people are already putting up in here. So here's another one, bedroom set. So I could do bunk, bed, bedroom, set, decor, children's, playroom, furniture, right? That's another one of the titles I could copy and paste, and all from there. Now, the only thing that you have to do at that point is just bump up the price so that instead of, you know, you selling it for 240 bucks, you maybe add 40 extra dollars so that just like that, you could have like a healthy profit, right? So after PayPal fees, this person would probably profit like $30 for every bunk bed that they sell. But the beauty about that is they don't have to actually own the bunk bed. The only time they have to buy this is after they'd already make the sale. So how this works, you see that there's three people that bought and it says, oh, it's the last one. It's not the last one, okay? Their supplier, I know for a fact, is coming from Walmart because they literally just copied and pasted the entire description here. As you notice, traditional design, pine wood construction. I wonder what this person also says. When we look at it, traditional design, convenient, all these words are pretty much similar to this. Features traditional sign, pine wood construction. Let's see if they put pine wood. Pine wood construction. Look at that, the exact same words as here, right? Even if I just put like the model number, let's see if there is a model number. There's not. Let's do this. Maybe the assembly directions. Okay, they have the product dimensions here and whatnot, right? But just from this alone, you know, they have the exact same keywords and descriptions as this right here, right? That's how we were able to come and find it from here. But yeah, that's exactly how it would work. Someone would come here, buy this that you copy and pasted literally from eBay for 292 bucks. You have the 292 bucks now. You literally go onto Walmart and buy it for 240 bucks. You ship it to the customer and then you keep the money. Oh, but Mike, what about the returns? Well, if you get a return, you just get a return label from Walmart and then ship it directly to your customer. And the craziest thing, you can do this with overstock as well. You know, a lot of people do this with, like, for example, bedroom furniture on overstock, as well as Wayfair.com, which is another place that you could get also things you could just copy and paste. Also Amazon.com, that works really, really, really well. A second way that you can make money by copy and paste is simply by just like using what is known as affiliate marketing for software. So this is a concept known as a ClickFunnels. It's a software that helps me build like my landing pages and websites and whatnot. And they give you these things where it allows you to sell like webinars and services and offers and even books. But here's like this book that I have, and you can see it right here. It's literally like this long book right here. But if someone literally goes through this funnel for free that I literally didn't have to like pay for, I didn't have to write the book myself, I could get $1 for the sale, then $14 for the upsell, then $38 for the upsell, then $99 for the upsell, then $125 for another upsell. I could potentially earn $737 in commissions. And the crazy copy and paste strategy that I see here is if I scroll down in any one of these things, they tell me exactly what to put in the email. So I can literally just type in this, copy and paste, and because I'm building an email list right here, I could come in here and just copy and paste the subject line as well as all of this. And just like that, I could go ahead and make money from it. All I gotta do is just kinda like space it out a little bit better, right, and whatnot. And if I send it to the specific link that it is right here, it would just get automatically sent to this funnel, which we could even go ahead and check what it looks like, right? Here's the affiliate ID. Now, if anyone goes and buy this book from my specific link, that this is literally what it would look like when you go to mikefasile.com/free book, you can see just by copying and pasting what to email, I could actually make money from this, from the hundreds of emails that I'm getting every single day for free without actually having to do this. Another way that you could also make money with this is, of course, with Munchai.com. They have all these big launches. Like, here's a good example of one. You know, this is known as Zappable, right? And the coolest thing about Zappable is they have a JV doc that will allow you to tell you exactly what to copy and paste in terms of the emails, and you could also make money with that. With this method, this is essentially a software teaching people how to build an instant mobile app maker. So that's pretty cool, right? And they have all these like different prizes and whatnot. $4,000, $5,000, $3,000 prices. That's pretty cool. But the coolest thing about this is you can make some serious money from that, right? Like one of the affiliate programs that I ended up getting from a creator that I got from Munchai.com, you could see from the commissions, we pulled in about $345,000 copy and paste strategy. And I just asked what emails were already working for you. They told me I sent those emails and just like that, I make money. With that being said, that's multiple ways to make money online just by copy and paste strategies. There's a lot even better ways to make money online too. Like you could see in the past 7 days, we've netted $7,000. In the past 14 days, we have netted about $15,000. And in the past 30 days, we have netted about, you know, $34,000 with, but today we pulled in like $1,900. A lot of these are even like better and simpler and more copy and paste. If you want to figure out how to do this, check out the free workshop below. This is able to happen with no product, with no service, with no customer fulfillment. And if somebody who's literally like a broke college student that was supposed to become a dentist with no tech savviness can do this, then why can't you, right? When you sign up for this week's free workshop, you'll also find out how a 62-year-old woman went from zero to 160% profit in 90 days. So check it out on the link below. As well as if you're new to the channel, check out my podcast of all these other multimillionaires that literally live here in Bali. I mean, this 11-year-old girl turned on $30 million. This man makes $1 million per month profit. And we reveal all these ways that all these people, to even like Wim Hof's brother, are making money online. So hopefully that helps. Love you guys. I'll see you guys later. Ew.